Australia's ambassador to Washington, Arthur Sinodinos, has said something explicitly today, which has sort of been around in the background of the AUKUS arrangement, which is essentially that nuclear submarines give us the capacity to be forward in a forward strategic position in the South China Sea rather than in the defence of Australia.
Give us a break. Give us a break. Yeah, yeah.
So essentially, what should our defence posture be right now within that strategic framework?
Eight submarines against China. When we get the submarines in 20 years' time, it'll be like throwing a handful of toothpicks at a mountain. A handful of toothpicks at a mountain. You know, I mean, Kim Beazley and I built the Collins-class submarines, you know. Kim always had the Admiral's hat on. I had the money and the guns, you know. I built the Collins, you know. I built the Anzac frigates. They were built for the defence of Australia. You know, their range was to stop any incoming vessels, military vessels against us. What Sinodinos is talking about are attack-class submarines to attack, to contain Chinese submarines, the hunter-killer submarines, to attack them and knock them out. You know, now, what's that got to do with the defence of Australia? And what possible impact could we have militarily with eight submarines, which might... Just say this about the submarines. These Virginia-class submarines were designed in the 1990s. The time we have half a dozen of them, it'll be 2045 or 50. They'll be 50 or 60 years old. In other words, our new submarines will be old tech. It'd be like buying an old 747, you know. And here we are, we're going to wait, you know, 20-odd years to get the first one and 35 or 40 years to get the lot, you know, for these what will be then very old boats. I mean, in fact, the newest submarine in the world, the newest design one, is a French low-enriched nuclear one. If we'd have been thinking, no, we need more range than the Collins can provide at 3,500 tonnes, we need to go to 4.5 or 5, the obvious choice, if we were unhappy with diesels, the obvious choice was the most modern submarine on the drawing board, which is the French nuclear submarine. No, no, we're rushing over. This has got, you know, the Liberal Party's fingerprints all over it. No, we're rushing back to the Americans, right? So we're going to rush back to a dated design with these things. But the whole point of these hunter-killer submarines is to round up the Chinese nuclear submarines and keep them in the shallow waters on the Chinese continental shelf before they can get into the Mariana Trench and become invisible. In other words, to stop the Chinese having a second strike nuclear capability against the United States, right? So this is the game we're now in. In the Collins game, we're in the defence of Australia. In the Virginia-class game, we are hunter-killing Chinese submarines. This changes our whole relationship, and that's confirmed by our ambassador. I mean, this is how stupid and bald they are.
How important is the the role of the French and the Europeans and other powers in showing an interest in the Pacific?
Oh, hugely important. Look, you know, the French had a great relationship with India because de Gaulle pulled out of NATO. The Americans pushed, like they pushed the Labor Prime Minister of Iran, Mossadegh, out in favour of the Shah. You know, everything they touch turns to you know what. They pushed Indira Gandhi away, and sure, she tied up with the Soviet Union. When de Gaulle turned his back on NATO, went independent, they developed a relationship with India. The French were introducing us into that relationship. In fact, the third meeting of India, France and Australia was to be held the week the submarine was cancelled. And so the meeting got cancelled. I mean, France is is the sole nuclear European power. Germany, a larger country, doesn't have nuclear weapons and doesn't have the sophistication of supersonic aircraft or nuclear submarines. The French have geographic assets in the Pacific. You know, it is strangely, but truly, a European power with a Pacific complexion. What do? We treat them appallingly. You know, we walk away from. I mean, if we're unhappy about the fact that we're having trouble trying to stuff a diesel engine into the hull of a French nuclear submarine, why didn't we at least inquire about their most modern nuclear submarine? You know, this is all about, you know, what's this young guy that works, that person works in PM&C?
Andrew Shearer?
Andrew Shearer. See, Andrew Shearer's this world. Can't wait to get the staplers back onto the Americans. And you've got the ambassador, you know, a local Sydney genius, out there telling us now, no, by the way, we want... Why would we need seakeeping for Australia's submarines in the defence of Australia that are able to stand off the Chinese coast 13 flying hours away if it's not to attack Chinese naval assets? And when you start attacking Chinese naval assets, you're a different state. See, look, the Chinese, hard-nosed as they are, would say, look, Australia's got these Collins-class submarines. They're effective, they're quiet, but they're not in our field. They're theirs, right? We're not going down there. We don't care. No, we're saying, oh, no. We've got a better story for you. We're going to get American nuclear attack class submarines that can stay on station. And you know what we'll do? We'll hunt your submarines down in the shallow waters of your continental plate. You know, beauty, you know.
So my final question to you before we go to my colleagues in Canberra is, coming back to your point about Indonesia and ASEAN, you say that they should be at the centre of our thinking.
Yeah, sure.
How would that work? I mean, are you talking about sort of liaison with the Indonesian army?
Well, look, I put together, as you know, a security treaty with President Suharto and the government of Indonesia and the army of Indonesia with Anzus words. It's the last thing I did as Prime Minister in November 1995, right? John Howard lost that with President Habibie over... our skiting over Timor. You know, Habibie suspended it. But you just imagine if we'd have spent the last 25 years putting Indonesian officers through our staff colleges, 25 years in security terms with Indonesia and its army, instead of Iraq and Afghanistan, instead of Howard's little escapades, if we'd have stuck to my script, imagine how much safer Australia would be now if we were back to that relationship. I mean, we have now just a peripheral relationship with Indonesia, the central state in our security. The central state geographically for our security is Indonesia. We have a peripheral relationship with them. And, of course, in ASEAN, every leader in ASEAN knows that we have no relationship with Beijing. So why would the Prime Minister of Malaysia or Singapore or Thailand talk to us about East Asia when we are non-speakies with the biggest power, the Chinese? If we'd have played our cards properly and weren't running off to Iraq and running off there, but focusing on where we live, on our geography, we would either be the Secretariat of ASEAN or at least a member. And where are we now? Nowhere.